very frenetic over there. So, you know, when people think of lame duck, Congressman, you don't think of this much activity around lame duck sessions.
Well, it's basically Nancy Pelosi thumbing her nose at the people of America who ordered a dramatic change in direction, and she's not going to honor that. She is going to continue down the path that she's taken us these last 2 years until the very bitter end.
I call it throwing a tantrum, Congressman. It's like, you know, kids in school, when they don't get their way, just throw a temper tantrum. That's what it seems like to many people watching the members of Congress, particularly Democrats, in front of microphones talking about this particular deal. Now, let me get your take. You've come out and you said you're going to vote yes for this tax cut proposal. Why?
Oh, absolutely, because without it, when that ball drops at Times Square on New Year's Eve, this nation will be walloped by a tax tsunami, the likes of which we haven't seen since the Smoot-Hawley tariff. I mean, families and small businesses are going to be spending the next year struggling to keep afloat while paying thousands of dollars of additional taxes.
When you look at the argument that's being put forward, particularly by the House Democrats, about the fact this upper 2%, these millionaires and billionaires, are going to get this benefit. Now, when they found that that wasn't gaining as much traction, when we see polls of the American people, by the way, ABC News, Washington Post poll, Congressman, showing 7 out of 10 Americans want this agreement to move forward. Now they pick on the estate tax, talking about all these rich people inheriting these big estates, when also they're talking about small farmers and small business people.
Those, exactly right. Those are small farms, small businesses that are family-owned that parents try to pass on to their kids. And you know, the thing about this death tax that is so pernicious is this. There is no incentive to make an intergenerational investment. I mean, if you're going to make an investment that will not come to fruition in your lifetime, the only incentive for doing that is because it will come to fruition in your children's lifetime and they will be able to benefit from it. The death tax destroys that incentive, and it's so critical for long-term economic growth.
When you look at this vote coming up sometime, is it still scheduled for today that you know of?
As far as I know, although it changes minute by minute. I'm serious. I mean, there is no schedule here. It's just at the whim of the speaker. That's going to all change, by the way, when the Republicans take over on January 5th. There is a very strong effort to restore transparency and predictability to the process now so that the American people and the members of Congress will know well in advance what's going to be taken up so that they have the time to look at it, study it, and debate it before it's brought up for a vote.